Hi, this is Mike Hendrickson at Velocity in Barcelona. I'm here with Kirby Wadsworth. Kirby, how you doing?
I'm good. Hi, Mike.
So you're with Limelight Networks.
That's right.
Can you tell us a little bit about what they do?
Sure. So Limelight Networks is a content delivery network. Our business is moving content from content owners, whether that's movie houses, game developers, or people with websites, and putting that in the hands of the audience that needs it. So.
And the audience that needs it, you just made an announcement recently about gaming solutions.
Yep. Yeah, so one of our segments that's particularly successful for us is the game developer, game distribution business. And we have a pretty healthy footprint in that marketplace. So this week we brought out a solution specifically targeted and tailored to the gaming development industry and the challenges associated with that. And there are many. There are multiple phases that a game has to go through, from development to distribution to updating and maintenance. Each one of those phases has some sort of content delivery challenge associated with it. And our solution provides a platform that a gaming company can address all of those challenges across that workflow, or selectively jump in to, solve a distribution problem.
So you have kind of the back end for developers of games.
We do.
Where you're actually helping those teams work distributedly better, more efficiently. And then you have the front end where you're actually helping deliver a high performance.
And even beyond just the delivery of the game, we also help companies deliver their game websites and the marketing related stuff associated with getting the audience to be involved in the game. So what we're seeing now is that it's much more prevalent for a gamer to have multiple screens around them while they're playing a game. Yeah. You know, they've got the little thing and then they're watching it on the TV, but they've also got an iPad next to them, because if they get stuck, they want to see somebody doing it. Or the other thing, which is really interesting to watch, is there's been a big uptick recently in people filming themselves to show their friends, hey, I made it through this really tough spot, or I killed that character, or look how awesome my character is, or whatever I've done. So there's this user-generated content. So user-generated content's gotten really hot lately, and that's takes up a massive amount of storage in the internet, because people are uploading those files, video files, and pictures of these characters and things, and then sharing them. So there's multiple aspects. Gaming is no longer just about playing the game. It's about an immersive experience related to all elements of the game. So we try to touch all of them.
So immersive experience, almost like publishing is too, it can be, or it's trying to move in that direction.
Does this
also apply to the media and publishing world?
Yeah, it does. In fact, it applies to media, broadcasting, obviously movies, because it's the same. Movies and games are so closely associated with each other now. So yes, it's the audience wants to have this multi-directional, multi-dimensional experience when they're, engaging in some sort of an entertainment experience online.
So if you were to talk to a CTO and a CEO of a gaming company,
yep.
From your perspective, what is their biggest benefit that they would get by working with someone like Limelight Networks?
So there are several, and it depends on which stage of development we're in, but let's say we have a game that's ready for distribution. This is the easiest one to understand. So when a large, format game comes out, especially around this time frame, around the holiday time frames, the distribution challenge to this is incredible, because everyone wants the game right now. So you're talking, 20% of the internet can get sucked up overnight when a Destiny or a Call of Duty version, whatever, comes out, because all these folks come in and want to download it. So you have to offload that distribution capability to somebody like us, or somebody who's in the business of delivering content on massive scale. And our challenge is doing that without taking down the 25% of the internet. But it's also making sure that the user has a great experience in doing it, because the experience of downloading the game is part of playing the game. Sitting there kind of watching it, go a little bar go across the screen, it's either a frustrating experience or it's a pleasant experience, because you're going to soon be able to play the game. So it's up to us to make it pleasant.
So you actually affect the user as well, because you know when they're loading their character, the quicker they load and get into the room or whatever they're doing, right, the sooner they can engage. And
well, you also have to remember, yeah, there's a lot of buildup about the game, and I want to play that game, but there are an awful lot of games. And what you're really vying for in this business is time, right? So it's about how much time can I get from my audience member. They have a lot of other things that they could be doing, and you want them to spend time with your game and your, you know, your the experience you're providing them. And if that's not a pleasant experience and it's not timely and it's not, you know, low latency, they'll go play somebody else's game or they'll go do something else.
So if we were to sit down here 12 months from now, well, actually it would probably be in Amsterdam, but if we were to sit down 12 months from now and have this conversation, what will have changed for Limelight Networks during that period? Mm-hmm. And also, where do you think the industry will be at that point? What's going to be important?
Yeah, so it's a great question. So the areas that we're really devoting a lot of time and energy to have to do with, let me back up one second. We have the distribution side of this down pat. We're very, very good at distributing large files across great distance at massive scale to any device anybody wants us to download them to. So we'll continue to get better at that, but that's not the real focus. The real focus for us going forward is about the other aspects of the gaming experience, the dynamic content acceleration associated with the game, or this user-generated content part of the game where that user content needs to be stored somewhere. So what you'll see from us is continuing increase in performance enhancements around the dynamic content nature. So that would be the side projects about, you know, search and looking up how your friends have gotten through difficult periods of the game and cheat sheets and that sort of stuff. Mobile is another area that you'll see a lot of improvement, because we just did a survey that we put out last week as well. More than 50% of the gaming world is not hardcore gamers that are playing Destiny, Call of Duty type games. There's half of them certainly do that. But the rest of the population, the you and I of the world, are playing these small casual games, the Angry Birds type games, those kind of things. And we're doing that in a very different way. We're playing those on our mobile phones, and we're playing those while we're standing in line, bored, waiting for something to happen, right? We just want to waste a couple of minutes or whatever, right? So there's a lot of development going on about that form of gaming, this new casual form of gaming, especially around mobile. So those would be the big areas of change in the next, you know, few months.
Can anyone help the airline industry speed up their wireless connections?
On the planes you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's probably a challenge beyond this conversation.
Well, thank you for your time. I look forward to that conversation next year.
Thanks for having us. Appreciate it.